If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. Yo, what's up guys? I am Rob. Welcome back to my channel. So I am back with another DIY project for you guys, and I'm telling you guys, you will really love this one. So today we are going to do salt water etching, and you can use this technique to personalize stuff, or you can make gifts for your loved ones, or you can actually use it for a science project for your school, because it's a great mix of art and science. But before we get into that, I would request you guys to click on that subscribe button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I would really appreciate that. And if you have already subscribed, then please click on the bell notifications icon so that you're updated whenever I put a new video up. All right, so let's get into the DIY project and let's do some art using the magic of science. Get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Alright guys, so let's get started. So now I'm going to show you guys the cool method of salt water etching. Before we do anything, we have to get our salt water solution ready. So here you can see I have salt and I have water, and in this glass we are going to make our solution. So what we'll do is, first we'll take 3 teaspoons of salt. This is just your regular salt, and once your salt is ready, you have to add some water to it. And then you just stir it, and you have to mix it well till the salt dissolves completely in the water and the water becomes clear. As you can see, the solution is completely clear now. That means that the salt has completely dissolved in the water and your salt solution is ready. Now what we'll do is we will dip some earbuds so that they are nicely soaked in this salt water solution. Alright, so now that our salt solution is ready, we can move to the next step. Alright, for the next step, we are going to take our surface where we will etch the design. So for that, I am taking this metal sipper, and on top of this, I am going to etch our design. Now, whenever you are etching a design, you have to make sure that your surface is clean. So I have wiped this clean. As you can see, it looks nice and clean. And now what I'm going to do is, I am going to place a stencil on this, and I am going to etch a design using a salt water solution. Now to make the stencil, I am using these vinyl sheets or vinyl paper, whatever the correct pronunciation is. You get them in different colors. This is basically like sticker paper. So you can draw your design on this and stick it onto the surface, and then you can cut it with a cutter or X-Acto knife. So right here, I have already done my design on this. As you can see, I have done a sketch of Iron Man. Now I am going to stick this onto the surface here. So let's stick this in place. And now I'm going to use my X-Acto knife and just cut the stencil out. So be careful. The vinyl sheet is pretty thin, so it cuts very easily. Okay, so I'm done cutting the stencil. As you can see, our stencil is now ready. Looks pretty clean. All right, besides your salt water solution, what you also need is a 9-volt battery and some crocodile clips. These are called crocodile clips because you can see they are like a crocodile's jaw, like that. Okay, so we have to do a very simple connection. I'm gonna show you guys how. So first we'll take this red clip and we'll attach it to the positive end of the battery, just like this. And once you have attached one end of the wire to the battery, you have to take the other end, and that you have to attach to the metal surface for earthing. So here I have my sipper, and I'll attach the clip to the surface. So you can see I have connected one end of the wire to the metal surface and the other one goes right here and is connected to the positive end of the battery. So this is basically earthing. And now we'll take the black wire and we'll connect it to the negative end of the battery. Now the other end of the black wire, I am going to connect to the earbud that has been kept soaking in the salt water solution. Now we're going to connect it like this, right at the tip. And now you can use this to etch the metal surface. All right, so let's start the etching process. So I'm just gently rubbing it on the metal surface. And you can see here, it automatically starts becoming black because the metal is basically corroding and it starts etching or becoming a different shade. Now, sometimes it starts bubbling or sometimes you will see a little bit of smoke or steam coming out. So make sure that you do this in a nicely ventilated area so that you don't consume the toxic fumes. But this is not really dangerous. Just make sure you follow the precautions and do it that way. If you want the etch surface to be slightly deeper, then you have to hold it in one place for a little while and slowly and gradually move it so that the etch design is slightly deeper. But make sure you do even strokes so that your etched design or surface looks nice and smooth. All right, looks like I am done. So now we can remove the connections and then we can peel off this vinyl stickle paper and see how our etching design looks like. Okay, I have peeled off the sticker paper and now I'm going to just wipe the design with a wet cloth and then let's see how this looks like. And there you go. You can see we have etched our Iron Man design onto our metal zipper. Looks pretty nice. This was my first time, so I am pretty happy with the result. Look at that. As you can see, there is an actual difference between the color of the etched surface and the original surface. Also, the original surface looks nice and glossy and shiny, and the etched surface looks more matte, and that's why you can see the difference. There you go, and your image is standing out. But like I mentioned earlier, you have to be very consistent and even with your strokes. Unfortunately, I wasn't. That's why in some areas it's slightly patchy, as you can see. But that's okay. I'm still very happy. Looks pretty organic and rugged. So yeah, that's the method of using salt water and a battery to etch designs onto a metal surface. So there you go guys, that's how you can do salt water etching. Like I said, technique is really simple, but the results are fantastic. It's a simple science hack that you can use to create art or personalized stuff. Works great for gifts. So if you're giving a gift to someone, you can use the technique to add their initials on a product, or you can add an image of something that they like. Basically, you can add anything or etch anything on a metal surface using this technique. So why don't you guys let me know in the comments below what you are going to make using this technique. Also, if you enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Please like it, I would appreciate that. Also share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, then please subscribe to my other channel, Rob in the Hood, where I put up vlogs. All right, that's the end of the video. I'll see you guys in the next one with another fun DIY. Till then, do good and be good. Peace.